You're watching WFTDA.TV.
Choose life. Choose a job. Choose a career. Choose a family. Choose a big television. Choose washing machines, cars, iPhones, and electrical tin openers. Choose not destroying your knees, no broken bones, and having dental insurance. Choose fixed interest mortgage repayments. Choose a starter home. Choose to wear pants and not having to wash pads stink off your body. Choose sitting on that couch watching mind-numbing, spirit-crushing game shows, stuffing junk food into your mouth. Choose rotting away at the end of it all, never having tried anything, never having pushed yourself. But why would I want to do a thing like that? I chose something else. And the reasons? There are too many reasons to count. But anyway, who needs reasons when you've got roller derby?
What are you two talking about? Roller derby! What are you two talking about? Roller derby!
Good afternoon, Derby fans. I am Sweet Willie T, and I'm joined by
Lightning Slim. Glad to be here.
Wow, what do we got on the docket for this afternoon?
Well, you folks at home on WFTDA.TV and everyone here in attendance, lucky enough to see the number 2 seed, the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls, versus number 3, Windy City.
And the story I think we see here, based on yesterday, we don't know what to expect from Rocky. They had a little trouble with Houston, but they were obviously experimenting with some stuff, Slim.
That's right. I think Houston gave them a nasty surprise in the first period of play, but they were able to pull out that victory against Houston, 246-102, but they really had to lock things down in the second half by reestablishing their system. But I think, as you were mentioning, Willie, we have not seen everything they have yet to offer.
Where we've seen most of what Windy has to offer, they came out of the gate and they played an unbelievably solid and disciplined game right from the get-go in there when they went up against the Mad Rollin' Dolls. So I think we've seen most of what Windy's got to offer. And speaking of that, who do we have out here for our team tonight? Rocky Mountain has got 122, Castrator 125, Rocks Your Socks Off 1896, Tootsie Roller 30, Rad Die 31, Fiona Grapple 37, Bob Blah Blah 378, Toxic Tonic 422, Gagan 719, Alpha Q Up 7423, Triple Shot Misto, number 8, Winota Fighter, number 86, Assault and Pepper, number 99, Make You Pay, and number M80, Sweet Mary Payne.
And for the Windy City Rollers, they are wearing the white today. 00 Tamikaze, 07 Jackie Daniels, 219 Who's Your Mama, 24 Wreckage True, 25 Arla Vendetta, number 30 Athena to Crime, 303 Kenichi Wow, 312 Killanoi, number 52 Sergeant Tina, 68 Moby Nips, 75 Bork Bork Bork, 777 Ying of Fire, number 81 Ruthanasia, and 999 Yvette Jamaker.
Right on time. We got 8 seconds to Derby here on the line. Sweet Mary Payne for the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls. She's going up against Jackie Daniels. And as everybody anticipates this, number 2 versus number 3, here we go. Payne pushed to the inside immediately by number 68. Nice job by Moby Nips. However, she's able to reset nicely and push that wall forward. Going nowhere is Jackie Daniels. Can't see who she's running into in that corner. As that skater is spun around in her face. The wall forms up. 99, Make You Payne cuts her off. Jackie Daniels going nowhere. Neither Jammer making any headway, Slim.
That's right, no lead jammer yet declared. Recycled to the back of the pack is the jammer of Rocky. Meanwhile, a wall at the front anticipating the Windy City jammer.
And things broke apart a little bit there, but it has reformed. Now we got some room. Jackie Daniels is your first lead jammer of this bout. It took her 40 seconds to get there as they pushed those walls all the way around the track once. Jackie Daniels ready to crash that wall from Rocky Mountain. Gets the hands on hips quickly. Did she sneak in a single point only? Nice job. Rocky Mountain just surged forward as she entered the pack. She had to call it off.
A bit of caution on both sides as these teams feel out each other's strategies. They've met each other twice before, and it is a 1-1 wash between them.
And now stepping to the line, number 25 for Windy City. That's Varla Vendetta. We didn't see a lot of her yesterday. We're going to see probably a little more today. She's up against Castrator for Rocky Mountain. Varla seemed to get a little bit nicked yesterday, had some medical attention, and I think they rested her because it was a fairly the game was in hand when that happened.
And Windy City ahead by one, 28 and a half minutes remaining.
And Varla goes down immediately, but she's able to push that wall forward. We had a no-pack situation for a brief moment. She's only got two blockers to beat, and she now sprints down the backstretch. Smile on her face, shaking her head. She is the lead jammer, Varla Vendetta. Meanwhile, back in the back of the pack, Castrator with two to beat and a solid hit from Kenichi. Wow, we'll see a lot of that tonight, Slim.
And track cut there. Going to Castrator, this is now a power jam for Windy City.
I don't know if Varla saw that. She immediately called off. She grabbed the points and called it off, unless this is a strategy for them to start this next jam in a power jam. I mentioned Kenichi Wow, watcher, excellent blocker for Windy City, Slim, and delivers a lot of those forced errors, forcing those track cuts on those jammers.
I would absolutely agree, Willie. And I think Varla Vendetta did call off that jam intentionally to get fresh legs on the track, those fresh legs in the personage of Athena to Crime.
And she stands on the Antic Boot start line and starts immediately pushing forward to the inside, but gets cut off. So she tries up the middle. Nice job as that wall forms. That is number 422. We saw a lot of her yesterday, Gagan, with some great hits. Unfortunately, she takes a penalty. I believe that was a multiplayer block. And threw it around the outside of turn number one, but it took her 15 seconds. Lead jam, power jam for number 30, Athena Da Crime. Slim.
She's working very effectively against this front wall of Rocky Mountain. You see, she skips around to the outside. There she goes again, another 5 points.
And Windy with this early 8-0 lead. They do have the power jam. Athena Da Crime dips her shoulder, cuts to the inside, cut off nicely. Great side-to-side movement by Rocky Mountain, but they can only slow her. They can't stop her. Five more for Windy.
But speaking of stoppages, the blockers of Windy City keeping this pack at a standstill as the jam comes to a close.
Right, she looked over to the bench, she looked over to the penalty box, saw that the opposing jammer was standing. So many teams doing that now, Slim, call it off. So they get the advantage, maybe get a quick lead jam right off the get-go.
On the jammer line now for Windy City, 777, that is Ying Fire, who did some heavy lifting for Windy yesterday and remained remarkably penalty-free despite the large number of points she put up.
Yes, and that was clear for the whole Windy City team. They played extremely disciplined, and they still played. I wouldn't say they played on edge, but they played near to the edge of what they can do, and extremely disciplined. It was excellent. Look at this push forward, Rocky Mountain. And I saw them warm up, Slim. They do a tremendous amount of footwork, and you saw it there as that two-wall was able to slow down Ying of Fire, but she is through. The power jam is over. She's your lead jammer.
Ying of Fire with some fancy footwork of her own and some composure. She falls there, but then returns immediately to the fray. More bodies fall.
And pretty much prone, flat. Her chin was on the ground. She called that jam off as three skaters went flying out of bounds. She did get a single point. 14-0, Windy, 25-21 to go in this first half.
We'd like to thank our good friends at PrintCoGraphics.com. You can lead the pack with new UV ink printing at PrintCoGraphics.
Jackie Daniel steps to the line. I believe that's got to be Alpha out there. The way she's bent, yes, number 719. Alpha, queue up. She put a lot of points on the board yesterday for Rocky Mountain. She did have a little bit of penalty trouble as well. And see if she can keep it clean today. And Alpha down the middle, pushing through that wall. And she's lead jammer for the first time tonight for Rocky Mountain, Slim.
That's right. Alpha did have a couple of ill-timed penalties early on in the bout yesterday, but she was able to regain her composure and become a very important part of that victory for them.
And finally through the pack, but off to the penalty box with a cut track penalty. Number 7, Jackie Daniels. And let's see what this Windy City penalty kill can do. Right now it's being led by number 00 Tamikaze, but they got to let her go. And Rocky Mountain gets the goose egg off the board with 5.
That was Windy City's first penalty of the bout, although it was followed very quickly by their second, and now they're 2 down.
And that makes it very tough. You see that a lot when you're on the power jam. You're at the power jam deficit. You're on the penalty kill. You do see a lot of blockers taking multiplayers out of plays as they try to burn the time off the clock and kill that penalty. And now it's a 14-10 with a minute to go in this jam. Alpha slowly engages the pack and just kind of slides by. some communication issues, I think, out there is number 52, number 00, Sargentina Tamikaze, straightening things out. And Alpha goes one more time. Now they're working nicely together in a solid shoulder, Sargentina. But Alpha gets through. Lead change, if you're playing at home, that was a 20-point power jam. Rocky Mountain in the lead.
Rocky Mountain pulling ahead now with a score of 20. Windy at 14, 23 and a half minutes remaining in the first half of play. And taking her turn on the jammer line for Rocky Mountain, it's number M80 Sweet Mary Payne.
And the Fight Club, the 5280 Fight Club coach is out there with a quick talk with Sugar Daddy. A little bit of clarification. So Sweet Mary Payne with Jackie Daniels standing in the penalty box. She's going to try to get that quick lead jam. Daniels out of the penalty box. Rocky Mountain forces her back deep into turn number four. And Rocky Mountain does have lead jam. Jackie Daniels gets cut off immediately at the jammer line. Has to go to bounce. She tries the outside. The same thing happens. Sweet Mary Payne now in there in that mix.
Yvette Shoemaker returning from the notorious RED penalty box. She's back in the mix. Now both teams at full strength.
And both walls setting up nicely. Sweet Mary Payne trying to push that wall forward for Chicago. They are doing a fantastic job of reforming it. However, it's eventually going to be out of play, but maybe not, as now the Jackie Daniels is able to surge forward. The pack reforms briefly, but Jackie Daniels gets knocked out of bounds. She'll have to go way back in turn number two. That breaks things up, and Sweet Mary Payne is allowed to go free.
So. Although not without much effort. She was held up for a great deal of time there by Kenichi Wow, Moby Nips, and Bork Bork Bork.
And that is a three-blocker lineup you'll see a lot of tonight for Windy City. And jam gets called off just as a penalty was called on the pivot for, I believe a penalty was called, yes, it was number 999. The pivot for Windy City off to the box, Yvette Shoemaker.
And that is her second penalty in as many jams. Yvette Shoemaker into a little bit of penalty trouble early on.
And we got a little vintage roller derby as our skaters have lined up on the pivot line. Of course, the pivot line not sponsored because nobody ever goes there anymore.
Indeed, they are both standing with a lot of space in front of them on that antique boot jammer line. I hope neither of them is agoraphobic.
Castrator going up against number 25 in the white, Varla Vendetta. Now they didn't speed up to that line, they just sort of coasted up, and we're now going to start the push cart war as they're trying to try and push that wall forward. Nice little move, number 25 around the outside, gets some space, gets
Ouch.
Cut off, so then Rocky Mountain uses that room, but a big crash in there. Sargentina taking down the Rocky Mountain jammer, number 00 Tamikaze off to the penalty box. Number 8 off to the penalty box, Winona Fighter for Rocky Mountain as the RED penalty box fills up. Lead jammer is number 122 for Rocky Mountain. Castrator, but hot on her wheels. Number 25 coming up in the white. Forces her to call that jam off, but great job by Castrator to put three more on the board.
And that's a 3-2 jam in Ooh. Favor of Rocky Mountain.
That she snuck two in.
Indeed, two more in there.
I love it. Varla Vendetta, I love it when jammers do that, when they go right to that fourth whistle and steal those points.
And so with 20:37 remaining in the first period to play, Windy with a score of 16, Rocky Mountain extends their lead to 30.
And it looks like we have a timeout on the field.
We'd like to thank the following WFTDA partners, Crazy Skate Shop Company, and of course, Green Monster. Thank you to both of you.
So Windy City taking a timeout only 10 minutes into this half. Interesting, they had a 16-0 lead. Now it's a 16 lead for Rocky. Back and forth. Maybe settle things down a little bit early in this bout.
No serious penalty trouble on either side. As previously mentioned, Yvette Shoemaker has two penalties. Tamikaze has one on the Windy City side. Jackie Daniels has a single also. And only a couple of skaters with singles on the Rocky Mountain side.
Alpha on the line against number 777 in the white. Ying of Fire and the whistle blew, but that was just to end the timeout. Alpha says, sorry about that. I didn't mean to go. And we're going to try it all over again. Alpha can't wait for this jam to go. She tries to go around the outside, gets cut off immediately, pushing that wall forward, number 777. Alpha with a great recovery to go inside, and now both jammers are through almost simultaneously. However, lead jam does go to number 77, Ying of Fire.
Ying of Fire has lead, but it is Alpha with room to skate as there are two blockers in the box for Windy City. Both jammers engage the pack simultaneously, and Ying of Fire calls it off.
And she waited to the absolute last minute there. Everybody trying to sneak in a bit of points, but nothing happened. As Supermax, junior derby announcer, and my son would say, no points for anyone.
Nothing neither way on that jam. Number 312 for Windy City taking to the jammer line. That's Killanoy.
And that'd be number 122, Castrator. Now that's interesting. This is the fifth different jammer for Windy City already, where it's a classic three-jammer rotation for Rocky Mountain.
Windy City doing a little bit more by committee. Illinois, jammer of the right now, bashing against the front blockers of Rocky.
Rocky with it all had her stopped, and then she made a nice move on the outside of turn number two. So Killanoy is your lead jammer. Windy turning their attention to Castrator. Excellent job by number seven, Jackie Daniels. We've seen her jam. We just saw her in the pivot position, slowing things down and allowing her jammer to get around and get only 3 points before she was taken out. But three well-needed points for Windy as they crawl a little bit closer. 30-19, 19 minutes to go in this half.
Killanoy took a little bit of a bump there and called off the jam from her knees. Perfectly legal for her to do that. The following jam brought to you by our good friends at Rydell Skates. Rydell, the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance.
Varla Vendetta, number 25 in the white for Windy on the line. Going up against Alpha Q Up, number 719. Alpha pushing that wall at the back. Windy City doing a great job. That pack now splits up. Jackie trying to push it forward a little bit more, and she is free. Lead jammer, the Windy City Rollers, got things locked down in turn number one, and here comes Jackie Daniels looking for the four and maybe going to shoot for the five.
Alpha has now escaped the pack. She's skating in the free and open spaces. And that's Varla Vendetta jamming four. Windy City, she gets four and calls it off.
That's right, and she looked to the referee holding up the four just to make sure there was agreement there. Everybody agreed, 4 points, nice jam for Windy.
I often find that jammers, whether they were before they began their derby careers, they all turn into mathematicians, Willie.
It's amazing how that happens, yes. And they developed a great relationship with their jam ref so they can communicate that and make sure some checks and balances out there.
In the pure language, mathematics.
It's a beautiful thing. Number M80, Sweet Mary Payne on the line for Rocky Mountain. Who's she going up against? Number 777, Yingo Fire. We've seen her more than once tonight, but Yingo Fire gets locked down to the back by number 99, Make You Pay, and that gives Payne some free, her Make You sister. Make You Payne is your lead jammer for Rocky Mountain.
Yingo Fire giving chase. However, on the scoring pass, Rocky Mountain
tried to push Payne to the outside. Nice job by number 00, Tamikaze.
And speaking of double zeros, nothing either way on that jam again, Willie.
That's right. Excellent job by that defense. So I think as things are playing out here, we're seeing Windy playing that same disciplined game we saw yesterday, and Rocky Mountain matching them point for point. In fact, with a 7-point lead with 17 minutes to go.
This next jam brought to you by our friends at FastGirlSkates.com. Our mission is educating skaters. Get schooled at Fast Girl Skates.
Killanoy up against Castrator. Castrator in the black for Rocky Mountain, trying to push that wall forward. Killanoy back and forth, left to right, takes a heavy hip to her midsection. Keeps on going, is now a two wall. Excellent job by Rocky Mountain. That horizontal movement they got, they can slow her, they can't stop her. Killanoy is your lead jammer.
Killanoy, a very smooth skating jammer, and she's coming around the track just like she teleported inside the pack, taking a bump there.
Nice job by Rocky Mountain. They will take a penalty on that, but they forced her out of bounds. Heading to the box is number 99, Make You Pay. And I believe that was that another nothing jam.
If you'd like to let us know how we're doing here on the broadcast at WFTDA.tv, you can use the hashtag on Twitter, hashtag talk, numeral 2, WFTDA, and tell us what's happening with your viewing party and how we're doing tonight.
So Alpha on the line for Rocky. Trying to see, looks like number 25. Yes, it is. Varla Vendetta for Rocky with the pack immediately split. Rocky Mountain on the pivot line. Windy on the jammer line. And that's how they continue. The walls have formed, but Alpha cutting down that inside. She's pushed that wall forward, gets driven to the outside. And now out of nowhere comes Varla Vendetta. Vendetta did not do it cleanly. She took a cut track on the outside of turn number two. Alpha with her second power jam of the evening, slowly coming around and analyzing that three wall of Windy.
And now Rocky with two blockers in the notorious RED penalty box, and a blocker and jammer in there for Windy. Lots of room for Alpha to skate.
And Alpha, she's the one that put the bulk of the points on earlier on that power jam. It was a 20-point jam. She's got five more going for 10, but there's triple nine. Yvette, your maker, back and forth working with Sergeant Tina. That is a formidable two-wall. Talk about horizontal side-to-side movement. Windy City taking a page of the Rocky Mountain book and holding her back. They can only do it for so long, Slim. There's another five.
She seemed to hold her back a moment too long despite the protestations of the referees, and does take an out-of-play penalty, and that is a full penalty box for Windy City.
It doesn't get any fuller than that, but that'd be one of those good penalties. Could have burned a little more time off the clock, and Alpha gets her hips in front, gets the points, calls it off with an acrobatic move. Only the left foot. I think there's only two wheels on the track when she finally called that one, Slim.
And now with 14 minutes remaining in the first half of play, Windy City a score of 23. Rocky has pulled ahead to 45.
What a fantastic technical bout as well. It's tough. I'm sitting here, I'm getting really into the bout, and I'm afraid I'm not getting as excited as I should be, but it's just so well played by these two teams. Now there's Mae Q Payne with Varla standing in the penalty box. However, gets the lead jam.
It is true, Willie, that this game is being masterfully played, and very calmly so.
And Mae Q Payne with a great move down the inside, but cut off. Konichi, wow. And Varla Vendetta, who's now just on her scoring pass, but she got through pretty clean. Mae Q Payne gets, oh no, Varla took the back block penalty.
That's two in a row for Varla Vendetta, and she joins Yvette Yermaker in the penalty box. Yvette Yermaker already on three penalties herself.
This 27-point lead is going to grow as Mae Q Payne battling up there up front. She's put a couple more on the board. She's got one to beat. I believe that's Konichi Wow. Yes, it is. And she is through for five, and the Rocky lead extends. That tough double penalty came out, got the back block immediately back in. Varla. And Windy City lining up again, doing a nice job near the pivot line, but there's a burst of speed. Mae Q Payne gets some room, down to only 2-1-9. Who's your mama? Finally has to let her go, and there's five more, calls it off, looks over. They're going to start this power jam, this next jam as a power jam, with still approximately 30 seconds left in Varla's penalty.
So another opportunity for Rocky to extend their lead. This has been a bit of a flinching contest. Windy with a newfound discipline, as we were discussing earlier, but they are seemingly unable to phase this Rocky Mountain squad, who up to this point are unflappable.
Of course, Rocky Mountain coming in the number 2 seed, the current ranking number 9. Windy City right behind them at number 10. They come in with identical 9-2 records. And we're seeing two very closely matched teams. However, the power jams, Rocky Mountain taking advantage of it, trying to do it right here with Castrator. Castrator pushing that wall forward. It's Sergeant Tina one more time, holding it down up front. Doing a great job working with Tamikaze. Driving to the outside. Oh, and she does get through. Burning 15 seconds off the clock. Castrator.
It could not be immediately seen on the screen, but Bork 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 was doing a tremendous bridging job there to allow that blocking to continue.
There's some teamwork. Bork 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 had a great game yesterday. There's Castrator pushing the wall forward one more time. Bork, 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 bridging things out, but through for five more. Varla got forced all the way back into turn number 4, trying to make that initial pass. She may be frustrated from those two consecutive penalties. Let's see if she can keep it clean. She can work around the outside. Nice burst of speed from Varla Vendetta. She's through, but here comes Castrator looking for four more before she calls this one off. She's got one to beat, and Sargentina drives the shoulder into her, and a great job of recycling. Tamikaze out of nowhere, and everybody takes a shot at Castrator. And that phenomenal bit of water falling allows Varla Vendetta to sneak out of nowhere for 3 points. What a jam.
Indeed, a 3-point steal, and that makes it a 3-3 jam. An interesting story here. Windy has the lead jam. They have the lead in lead jams. They have 9 of them to Rocky Mountain 6, but Rocky has taken advantage of those power jams, and the tale unfolds itself on the scoreboard. Rocky at 68, Windy 26, with 11 minutes remaining in the first half.
Alpha on the line against number 777. Ying O Fire bursts up to the pivot line, where she is met by the Rocky Mountain defense. They're working over pretty hard. Nice job, number 125 in there. Rocks your socks off, keeping her at bay. She's got a little bit of room. A skater goes down, and now she's got a bit of an escort up there of Windy City Rollers, and number 777 Yingo Fire is through. Windy turns their attentions to Alpha. Sargentina with a big hit, and then she gets the return favor from 99 Mae Q Payne, living up to her name.
Rocky Mountain penalty to Fiona Grapples. She will sit.
And Windy with their first 5-point jam of the evening. Excellent job. Not their first 5-point jam, says John Madding, and I won't argue. I'm just seeing if he was paying attention, and as always, he was. And getting dropped in turn number two, but quickly back on her feet. Ying of Fire with a burst of speed. And that is her 4 points more on the board for Windy City, and the lead gets cut to 68-35, 9 minutes, 55 seconds to go in this one, Slim.
Windy serving some notice that they are certainly not out of the running yet and are maybe starting to figure out the puzzle, the enigma that is the stone wall of Rocky right now.
Yes, Rocky playing excellent defense. Windy doing a decent job discipline-wise, but they have taken those three jammer penalties, which were costly, and that's made the difference so far.
However, Sweet Mary Payne and Killanois, jammers of the right now.
Killanois got cut off to the outside. Excellent job, Mae Q Pay. She's all over the track tonight, forcing Killanois back way deep in this line now. The return favor goes to Mae Q Pay, Sweet Mary Payne. Payne is through as your lead jammer, but bursting through after she got some room. Hot on her wheels is number 312, Killanois, in the white for Windy, so the jam gets called off.
And another double goose egg. No change to the score after that jam.
Almost like a chess match, very hard-hitting chess match. A full-contact chess match.
Full-contact chess. And this full-contact chess is brought to you by our friends at Cruz Skate Shop. That is Cruz with a, what I would call a letter Z, CruzSkateShop.com, offering quality-tested derby gear and guidance since 2007.
Athena DeCrime on the line against number 122, Castrator. That three-jammer rotation still continuing for Rocky Mountain. However, five different jammers for Windy, and right now Athena DeCrime pushing that wall forward in turn number two.
Castrator held in the rear momentarily, but now making a burst into the center.
And Windy City able to reform the wall again, driving Castrator to the outside, but Athena the Crime ran into a whole lot of troubles. Number 74-23, triple shot. Mistu, some great defense.
A heavy waterfall all over Castrator. Sargentina going to work on her, and plenty of follow-up hits.
And it's now a power jam for Rocky Mountain, as you saw. Off to the penalty box was Athena the Crime. Did not see what the call was for, and look over, it was a cut track. And you got to give that one the credit. Goes to triple shot Misto, who was all over Athena DeCrime. Now, that Windy City defense tightens up. A little bit of a surge forward from Rocky Mountain. It was a feint. They let it go. Sargentina with a hard hit. She looks back, says, come on, back to the pivot line. Looking around is Castrator. Castrator says, no pack. But nope, too late. She is off to the penalty box for a cut track.
Triple shot Misto going to the penalty box for Rocky also. She is about to be joined by Castrator herself, and the tables will turn on this power jam.
That's right. You're going to see Athena the Crime hop up any moment now and get out there. She's got four blockers. Rocky Mountain with a full penalty box. They're only going to be able to respond with two. Athena the Crime down the inside. Rocky Mountain is happy. They've got a chance to get some points. Only 30 seconds left in this jam. Athena DeCrime, she's going to be facing a three wall if she doesn't hurry up, and there it is. It forms in front of her. She's got to push it forward down the inside. What a great job. Oh, and they could not hold her. Coming out of nowhere was number 31, Fiona Grapple, out of the penalty box.
Ferocious blocking by Windy City forced the track cut, which has caused this power jam to happen, and Athena DeCrime taking full advantage. There she goes again.
Full advantage, full 15-point advantage. With only 2 seconds left in this jam, but they're going to start the next jam. It'll be continuing a power jam. 6 minutes to go. 73-45. Rocky in the lead, but Windy with a little bit of momentum right now, Slim.
Indeed. Windy with momentum. Penalties now even on, seemingly even on both sides, as Rocky Mountain tallied up a few in a row.
Varla Vendetta on the line for Windy City. She's got a four wall in front of her, and she pushes it to the outside. She's looking for some help from from Bork Bork Bork. She gets it and gets down the inside. 7:42 out of the penalty box.
But in going to the penalty box is Varla Vendetta. She is not troubled by that knee injury from yesterday, but she is troubled by these penalties.
That's right. Another forced error by Rocky Mountain, and they are close, close calls. Varla's just on the edge. Number 122, Castrator. She started out in the penalty box. She is now in the power jam. She slowly approaches that Windy City defense. Bork, Bork, Bork on the outside. Kenichi Wow getting steered by her teammate Moby Nips. Nips using her as a weapon. Kenichi Wow driving her out of bounds. You're going to see that all day long. As I said, Kenichi Wow is an expert at jammer takeouts. Now Sargentina, or pardon me, Bork 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 and Moby Nips working together, trying to stretch it out, bridge it as far as they can. Bork 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 says, all right, I will let her go. But what a great penalty kill. Rocky gets the points, but they burn a good 30 seconds off that clock, Slim.
That was pure metal from Windy City, by which I mean Tenacious D. They were holding up Castrator and not allowing her to get the gift that was the power jam she discovered upon coming out of the penalty area.
And that was textbook. They started out with three blockers. As the pack moved forward, Kenichi Wow dropped back to bridge, and he only had Bork 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 and Moby Nips, and they worked so well together, and they stretched out as long as possible to burn that off. Textbook penalty kill.
Only two blockers, but two was more than enough.
Sweet Mary Payne now pushing that wall forward, and they're doing it again. They got to stretch it out. Good job by Sargentino to stretch it out, but Sweet Mary Payne is through for Rocky. Standing in the penalty box is Varla Vendetta. She is going to come out, and she's going to have to come way back in turn number four. Rocky loves to do that to the opposing jammer.
They pulled her all the way back, but now she's back on the track.
And Sargentina drops a shoulder into Sweet Mary Payne. She got the 4 points, pardon me, the 5 points, but she also got a solid shoulder from Sargentina to show for it. Off to the penalty box goes Fiona Grapple for Rocky. However, it's in control. It's in the hands of Sweet Mary Payne, as that Rocky defense is giving no room to Varla Vendetta.
Fiona Grapple reaches the penalty box, sits down in the notorious RED penalty area.
Varla looking for a bit of help, trying to get a whip.
Ouch.
She got, yes, whipped right into Mei Q Pei, who has lived up to her name more than once tonight. Jam gets called off. 5 more points. Rocky with an excellent recovery from that little bit of a run that Windy had. It's now 88-45, 3 minutes 20 seconds to go in this one, Slim.
We would like to thank our friends at Fifth Blocker Skates, fifthblockerskates.co.uk. Don't be scunnered. We've got hundreds of stuff at Fifth Blocker Skates.
Number 312 in the white for Windy City, Killanoy on the line against Alpha. Number 719 in that black, or as our good friend El Blamo says, I think it Mountain Slate. He's got some fancy name for those beautiful gray and black uniforms from Rocky Mountain.
It is a granite-y sort of color. I would agree with him there. Oh, stumbling there, but quickly regaining her skates and lead.
Nice job. That, of course, is Killanoy. She took a heavy, heavy hit there from Toxic Tonic, but she kept things alive.
Toxic Tonic receiving a penalty on that hit also, and having to take a seat in that notorious RED penalty box, sponsored by the notorious RED gear deodorant. Play dirty, smell clean.
But a nice quick points, 4 points for Windy with 2 minutes to go. I think they'd like to get a little bit of a run here to take some momentum into halftime, although, you know, this has been a great defensive, strategic chess match of a battle. It continues with Castrator on the line, number 122 up against number 07, Jack E. Daniels, the legendary Jack E. Daniels. Now both jammers trying to push that wall forward together, working together for a brief moment, but getting knocked out of bounds was Castrator. Whole lot of room for Jackie Daniels, lead jammer. She's got a chance for a full five if she can crash that wall as it reforms by Rocky Mountain. They cut her to the inside. She tries to push forward. She's on her toe stops. She moves now to the outside and gets a little bit of help from Sargentina. Give her the assist. She only gets 4 as Castrator was able to break through that pack. She calls it off, Slim.
Jackie Daniels looking to her bench for the instruction and not waiting until she received it before she called off that jam, but there you go. That's another one in the bag, and just about a minute and a half remaining. Rocky at 88, Windy 53 points.
Yingo Fire on the line against Alpha. Looks like only one Rocky skater in the penalty box right now. Just about everybody standing on that Antic Boots start line. And with only a minute to go in this one, here we go one more time. Windy pushing forward, 7-7-7, Ying of Fire. She's got some room. She's got one to beat. Great recovery by number 99. Oh, and what an athletic move. And a smile on her face and blew a kiss to the crowd.
Simultaneous offense and defense as the blockers of Windy City holding up Alpha Q up. And Ying of Fire taking a hit there.
And Ying of Fire, she is showing strength, she is showing speed, and those fancy moves to get around to get that lead jammer. 4 points, 30 seconds to go in this one. We will get one more jam in, 88-57. And to get that last jam in, we got 3-1-2 on the line for Windy. Killanoy is at a solid first half. She's going up against somebody who's doing a lot of the heavy lifting today. M80 Sweet Mary Payne for Rocky.
And Sweet Mary Payne, despite doing that heavy lifting, Willie, is without a penalty as yet in this contest.
And that bodes very well for Rocky Mountain. Great outside move. Getting some space up there. Killanoy, two blockers to beat. Great job by Rocky to reform that wall. So Killanoy has to try the inside. Now sneaking up behind her and using Killanoy to break through. It was Sweet Mary Payne. That's one of those times, Slim, where you follow the other jammer through the pack and she opens things up for you.
Sure, like a trail of breadcrumbs.
Beautiful job by Sweet Mary Payne. Oh, and a nice little hop move in there. She did get hit, but she got the point, spun her hips around. Sargentina not happy. She's saying, that was too close to call, but great job by Sweet Mary Payne. We're going to halftime 91-57. So let's think back, Slim, to how we open this boat off, talking about what we expected from these two teams. What have we now seen?
Well, we saw the discipline that we expected from Windy, but I think they have been momentarily stymied by an even greater level of discipline from the Rocky Mountain squad. Windy having 12 lead jams and Rocky with 10, but that's not what we see on the scoreboard, as Rocky is taking advantage of some serious power jams.
That is correct, and that's been the difference. But both teams playing so well strategically, playing so well disciplined. This is excellent, excellent derby. Not as fast and frantic and hard-hitting as the Gotham-Minnesota game that we just saw. It's definitely much more like a chess match now. A lot of big hits out there, but it just seems to be moving at a very different, meticulous pace, disciplined pace. I'm really enjoying it. I don't know about you, Slim.
It's a smaller derby, but I agree, it's absolutely masterful. Now, before we go, I would like to give an update on Columbia skater Fearless Fritz. She was taken out on a backboard during their game versus Steel City. We would like to, happy to report, that she is okay. She has aggravated an old neck injury. It is currently being evaluated, but she should be fine.
That's right. And the backboard, essentially, I talked to some of her teammates, it was more of a precaution. She came with this pre-existing injury, and of course our crack EMT people taking care of, you know, doing everything possible to make sure, but it sounds like she's good. It's too bad she's out of the tournament. Fritz is a great player. Glad to hear that she's going to be okay though.
My name is Lightning Slim. I am here with Sweet Willie T. We will be back with the second half of this contest after this.
Rein in. Keep going. Oh, time for an upgrade. Radar Presto.
Say, these are nice.
Stunning.
On you go.
Brenda Gold, and I've been at Riddell for 36 years almost. Everything is done by hand, basically. Just a one pair actually going through at a time then. And some of them are multiple colors where it'll have 5-6 colors, metallics, the different colored full grains, you name it. Some of them are pretty wild. To me, the skaters are really important because that's what keeps us going here. It's the consumer or the skater that decides, okay, is it good enough for me or not? We want them to be happy, that's for sure.
Derby fans. I am Sweet Willie T, joined by Lightning Slim. Wow, what a first half, a cerebral first half.
Definitely a war of wills and of intellect. None of the big marquee hits that maybe people might be looking for, or foot races or anything like that, but certainly a very smart level of derby being played between the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls and the Windy City Rollers.
The way the walls were built, the way the waterfalls were done, very timely. The way the jammers were controlled by the blockers. It was amazing, the bridging that we saw. We saw Sargentino with some incredible, Bork, some incredible bridging, stretching things out. That's why we're only at 91-57 after a full half derby.
And I would say what accounts for the difference you see on the scoreboard, because both of these teams have been able to pull off these strategic maneuvers and pull off these set plays. As we say so often in modern roller derby, it's the power jams.
That's right. However, was it 6 power jams for Rocky Mountain in this one?
Yes.
And they only have a 34-point lead. So some good defense by Windy.
Right.
They could not stop the bleeding, but they certainly kept it to a minimum. So there's still, you know, not that big point differential after a 6-1 power jam differential.
What I'm curious to see in the second half is if Windy City does a bit of a jammer retool, because they were relying heavily on Varla Vendetta, but she's currently sitting on 3 penalties. They may not want to use her quite as much in the second half, or they may just want to keep her going until she's no longer viable, and then switch. It's a decision they're going to have to make.
But they've got 5 jammers they've been using in that first half, so they do have a lot of depth. Maybe in the second half we'll see that they found somebody's having more success than another jammer. Rocky Mountain, however, using that 3 jammer rotation. Castrator, Alpha, Sweet Mary Payne doing all the heavy lifting for them, and the rest of the team playing that excellent defensive blocking.
Castrator sitting on 2 penalties, but Sweet Mary Payne has none at all, and that could be very important in the second half, which is about to begin.
And you can probably hear the crowd getting ready to go nuts. The announcers going nuts in the house here. And there she is, Sweet Mary Payne on the line against number 777, Yingo Fire, who did have a good first half for Windy City. Now, Windy pushing things forward. Yingo Fire works to the outside, gets pushed, unfortunately, out of bounds. Oh, somehow keeps those toe stops in. Wow, that was a great move in turn number 1. Yingo Fire is your lead jammer, but only 10, maybe 15 feet behind is Sweet Mary Payne. Ying says, I'm not even going to try it because the Rocky Mountain blockers had pushed up so far, and she calls it off.
Kenichi Wow taking a seat in the penalty box. That means there will be 1 skater from each side in that box to begin the next jam.
Now, here's a question for you, Slim. What do Kenichi Wow, Lightning Slim, and Sweet Willie T have in common?
I am not sure, my friend.
They are all Canadian. There you go.
Cat is out of the bag.
There it is. It's true.
I don't know if anybody would have noticed, eh?
I know, but all of a sudden the accents come out, and here we go, number 07, Jackie Daniels for Windy City. However, she's trapped in the back of the pack, and Castrator with 1 to beat, skating backwards, gotta let her go. And Castrator is lead jammer for Rocky Mountain with that 91-57 lead. And a half a track behind is Jackie Daniels. Castrator going to make a run. It's only a 3 wall up there. Going to try and get some points. But there goes the pack. It pushes forward in a big burst of speed. Jackie Daniels. No points for anyone.
Look at Jackie Daniels closing that gap with this burst of speed. Just
wow.
Tremendous athleticism. And I mean, we have come to expect that from her, but it's still a beautiful thing to behold.
And the other thing that was beautiful, the timing of it, the way her teammates surged forward to keep Rocky Mountain from getting those hips in front to get any points, just as Jackie Daniels put on the jets and, yeah, it had to be called off with no points. I believe that's Alpha on the line.
She is joined by Killanoy.
And they both go up to the pivot line.
Oh, Alpha taking a hit there from Sargentina.
That was a solid hit. We've seen her do it several times tonight. Sargentina, excellent block for Windy City. And getting stretched out, Alpha in turn number 2. She could not stay in bounds, so there's a whole lot of room for number 3-1-2.
Alpha spilled again by Sargentina, and a third time. Down she goes.
And she draws. She takes the cut track penalty. She
Indeed.
Doesn't know it yet. She's still there. She finally skates out of bounds, and it's a power jam for Killanoy. Noy up at the front with only 2 to beat. Rocky Mountain back and forth. Can't stop her. This could be a huge start to the second half for Windy, as they've got the full 4 wall that Killanoy's got to deal with. She engages it at the back of turn number 4. Goes left, goes right, puts her hands up. Got nowhere to go. What a great job by Rocky Mountain. They're going to have to bridge now a little bit as Killanoy's able to push things forward. So stepping back into the bridge is number 30, Rad Dye. And it stretches out almost to the pivot line, but a good 25 seconds burned off the clock. 5 points for Windy, but the Rocky Mountain defense.
Textbook bridging and holding to eat up some time on that clock to allow Alpha some time in that penalty box so she can come out.
Let's see if Killinois is going to face that same thing again, and it's almost carbon copy. There's that three wall surrounding her. Now 378, Toxic Tonic steps back to bridge, and finally getting her hips in front and getting the points and calling it off because standing in the penalty box is Alpha. That will give a little bit of an advantage. Looks like we got out there for Windy, number 30, Athena DeCrime. She's going to have a few second head start.
That was a bit of a miscalculation on Alpha Q-Up's part because she was rolled like a wheel by Sargentina, but immediately stood up and continued skating, and that is what incurred the penalty. But her teammates on Rocky Mountain have minimized the damage.
Yes, they have, and they've been doing it all night long. And there she goes, Athena DeCrime, pushing the wall forward, coming back onto the track in turn number four, and wiping out was Alpha. That'll give a little bit more room to Athena. She is your lead jammer. She is on her scoring pass. Alpha trying to get past that pivot line and that big wall of white in front of her, and big in the sense that they are going left and right and cutting her off to the inside. And it's Kenichi Wow in the middle of that mix, as she always is. Athena DeCrime through for five more, and Windy cuts the lead to 15.
Alpha has returned from the notorious RED penalty box, but she is continually buffeted by the defense of Windy. There, they're at it again. She is pushed out of bounds in turn number two.
Oh, and taking a three or four step run was Mae Q Payne at Athena DeCrime. Drove a shoulder into her sternum. I don't know how Athena stayed on her skates. She's going for more. Nice bit of recycling is coming up to help out. Is number 37, 378, Toxic Tonic. But that pack finally has to let her go. Athena gets the 5 points. But the defense for Windy City Alpha going nowhere. She has only made it three quarters of the way around the track. She's still on her initial pass. Kenichi Wow cutting her to the inside, drops her. Kenichi Wow, what a hit.
Penalties piling up here for Rocky Mountain here on the defense as two blockers head to the penalty area. Alpha re-engaging with the pack there. You see her at the back of the pack.
And this is a very large power jam for Athena DeCrime. It started out as a power jam. She has turned it into the jam of hers under control. With those only two blockers, if she can get a five more points, we're going to have a tie game. If you're playing at home, it's 91-91. Jam ends, 24 minutes to go. Wow, Slim.
Oh, there. And a roar from the crowd in attendance. This is exciting stuff. As the power jam, you're right, Willie. It was started out as a power jam and sort of stayed that way as Alpha returned from the penalty box but was under the complete control of the defense of Windy City.
The Windy defense was just amazing. I called them a big wall because they were all over the track. It didn't matter whether they had two blockers in front of her or four. They completely controlled left to right, took her out of bounds on the inside, took her out of bounds on the outside. She had nowhere to go.
I got a big wall at my house, but it is not that flexible.
That was unbelievable defense by Windy City. Now it's 7-7-7. Ying Fire on the line. Well, now she's way past the line there in turn number two against Sweet Mary Payne for Rocky, and both jammers getting rocked around a lot. Pace picked up a little bit, hits picked up a little bit. The chess match getting a little more physical. Oh, and going down on her knees and quickly up, but then
ouch,
gets dropped. And that was a solid hit by number 37. That was Bob Loblaw who dropped. 7-7-7, Yingo Fire, lead jam is in the hands of Sweet Mary Payne for Rocky. She's going to try to put Rocky back in the lead. Big collision there in turn number one. She wins that one, stays on her skate. She's got one to beat, calls it off.
And that will put an end to a 34-point scoring run by Windy. Over the previous two jams, Windy had 34 points to Rocky's zero. But Sweet Mary Payne putting an end to that, and Rocky pulls ahead by 3 points, 94-91.
I've seen that several times on the Rocky Mountain roster. Sweet Mary Payne is one of those good settle-down jammers. She seems to go out there, and if things getting a little out of hand, can kind of reel things back in for her team and stop those scoring runs.
The following jam brought to you by our friends at Adam Wheels, proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA. Fiona Grapple sitting on four penalties at the moment.
Nice little jammer-on-jammer action as Castrator taking Jackie Daniels out. So they all reset and do it one more time. This time Daniels sneaks around Castrator and then engages the Rocky Mountain blockers. Tries to push them forward. One skater going backwards. Daniels going sideways down the inside of turn number one. Number 68 with a great jammer takeout on the outside for Windy City. That was Moby Nipt. Castrator got to start all over again. But meanwhile at the front, Jackie Daniels gets through finally out of sheer tenacity. Jackie Daniels is your lead jammer for Windy. Down by three. She could score a quick four here, but she gets hit immediately and knocked to the inside, scrambling now to get those points before.
And does she have the three or four she needs? She has three, and I think, and a two-point steal by Rocky Mountain at the end of the jam. The teeter-totter just keeps going here, Sweet Willie.
Oh, that is unbelievable, and our chess match has taken a little bit turn. The chess is continuing, but the speed has picked up of the game. 3-1-2 on the line. Killanoy going up against 378. Toxic Tonic, first time tonight. Toxic's on the line.
Rocky Mountain with 19 penalties to Windy City's 13 as it stands.
Tonic gets driven to the outside, but so does Killanoy. They both start over again. However, Tonic had to go way back, and then she runs into a heavy hit from Sargentina. Now with almost a full track advantage, Killanoy coming around to engage those Rocky Mountain blockers. It's a three wall, and they take her out. She's got to go back, and she looks and says, oh, no, here comes Toxic Tonic. She's going to have to call this one off quickly. Spins her hips to the inside, calls it off. Did get 2 points, and what does that mean, Slim?
I do believe we're tied up once again, Sweet Willie.
20 minutes to go.
Oh, my.
Wow, Rocky Mountain going into the second half with that lead we talked about. Windy City quickly closing it now. Back and forth. Will this continue for the next 20 minutes? I say yes. I hope so, because this is incredibly exciting derby. Yingo Fire on the line against Sweet Mary Payne.
This jam is brought to you by Bruised Skate Noose, the original over-the-shoulder roller skate holder.
Everybody pushing that pack forward. However, getting driven to the inside was Ying of Fire, or part of the outside was Ying of Fire. She now goes down to her knees, then runs into the opposing jammer, but is able to bounce forward. Now down the inside, great move. Sweet Mary Payne is your lead jammer for Rocky Mountain. Off the penalty box goes Bork, Bork, Bork. Sweet Mary Payne coming up to that three wall from Windy City. They drive her to the inside. Konichiwao one more time doing it.
Ying of Fire has escaped the pack also. Oh, what a hit there by Konichiwao.
Yes, and she's a very solid hitter. You see her play a lot of that finesse game in the sense of steering jammer to the inside, steering jammer to the outside, but she shows you there she can drop the hits.
Sweet Mary Payne pointing an accusing finger at Konichiwao as she skated off the track, but no response from the officials.
Interesting. And Sargentina off for some repairs over by our medics. Looks like she blew out a skate lace, and she is quickly relacing that skate. That's going to hurt Windy for the few minutes it'll take for her to get back there. She's been outstanding on that Windy City defense. Number 25 on the line. That, of course, is Varla Vendetta for Windy City as she goes up against number 122, Castrator.
Ouch.
Varla gets dropped in turn number two. Quickly back on her feet, but gets driven to the inside by number 742. Triple shot, Misto. So she is now at the back of the pack. Castrator with a half a track lead. Varla gets a little bit of room. Sidesteps a big hit from Make You Pay. But the chance to make them pay on the scoreboard is Castrator looking for those points. Gets in the wall of White, moves forward quickly. They just, oh, that was beautiful, Slim. She did get 2 points, but just as she approached that Windy City wall, they all surged forward a little bit. She could only get her hips in front of two. Did not get the four, only got the two. She wanted four, didn't get it. 101-96.
Just about 18 minutes remaining in the contest. This has been back and forth all evening, folks.
On the Antic Boots start line, 0-7. Jackie Daniels up against 719. Alpha. Daniels on the inside. Alpha in the middle. Daniels now kind of following Alpha. She steps out to the outside. Alpha still pushing forward in the middle. Daniels trying to make her own hole in turn number two. She gets cut off and pushed to the outside. Keeps battling down the inside. She's now got only a two wall to deal with. They drive her to the outside. Jackie Daniels is your lead jammer.
Rock solid play there by Daniels. And she's just as quickly around the track. And there she is in the pack.
And Konichiwao, chalk her up for another jammer takeout as she is working on Alpha. Alpha's going to have nightmares about her engagement with Konichiwao, who's now forcing her back in turn number three. But great Great job by Rocky to do exactly the same thing. Triple shot Misto and both jammers go back to the old pivot line to start this one again. However, Daniels is on her scoring pass.
Assault and Peppa heads to the penalty area on a forearm penalty. Alpha skating in the free and open spaces, but the jam is over, and Jackie Daniels has five.
That's right, and she got that fifth point. She did get her hips in front of the opposing jammer before it got through. Are you
kidding
me?
Surprise, surprise, yes. What's happening, Sweet Willie? What is happening on the scoreboard?
Well, I tell you what, it would be a tie game. So we've got 16 minutes to go, 60 minutes, 48 seconds, and really nothing has been decided other than this is a fantastic derby bout.
Plenty of nervous moments for people who have filled out their cheese balls bearings bracket. You can check out how to do that for upcoming tournaments on cheeseballs.com, but if you've already filled it out, you just have to sit and watch it all unfold.
Sweet Mary Payne up against Ying of Fire. Looks like a multiplayer bot getting called over there, so Sweet Mary Payne working down the inside, and she is your lead jammer. Rocky with a chance to take the lead, however.
Sweet Mary Payne holding her face and calling off the jam. She seems to be in a little bit of pain. She decided she did not want to continue.
And she immediately took off her helmet as she got to the bench and threw it down, and hopefully she is okay. Because Rocky employing almost exclusively a three-jammer rotation with her at the center of it. I hope she is okay.
She is turning to her teammates and seems to be kvetching a little bit about what has happened, but not in obvious further pain.
And Castrator, number 122 on the Antic Boot start line, standing 5 feet behind that Antic Boot start line, it was Killanoi. Now they're both there. They're both engaging their respective walls that are trying to stop them. Around the outside goes Killanoi. Takes a heavy shoulder but stays in bounds. But down the middle, the hole opened up. The seas parted ever so briefly. Castrator is your lead jammer for Rocky Mountain. Will Rocky Mountain break this tie? Windy City surging forward nicely. Rocky did get some points, and she jumps out of bounds, calls it in the air.
No points for Windy, and we await the score for Rocky. The referees are discussing whether or not a penalty was warranted right at the end of the jam there. And two points for Rocky. And we are now at 103-101 with 15 minutes remaining.
The Windy City Rollers on that Antic Boots start line. We're waiting for Rocky Mountain to come out. Well, it looks like we're going to get a timeout called by Rocky Mountain.
And that may have been a timeout because they had not yet fielded their jammer and were in danger of having her unable to reach the track in time.
Yes, right you are. And if so, a smart, smart play by the coach. Unfortunately, got into that position. Was that caused possibly by Sweet Mary Payne? Maybe unable to return to the track just yet. Remember, she did take that...
Possibly a miscommunication between her and the coach. Yes, Sweet Willie, I think you may be correct in that. Of course, three timeouts available in the period, and you can't take them with you. So a well spent, I think, by Rocky there.
And coach, giving Alpha a hug and some encouragement there. Some strong words from the coach, a lot of nodding. He's got to be happy with Rocky, what Rocky Mountain's doing so far.
You can talk directly to thousands of Derby fans. Advertise on WFTDA.tv. Affordable packages are available for your business, a boot camp, or tournament advertising. Visit WFTDA.com/sponsor/opportunities to learn more.
Varla Vendetta for the Windy City Rollers in white, going up against those cool slate-colored jerseys, and that's Alpha, number 719. These two renewing acquaintances talking a little bit out there. They have jammed against each other several times tonight, both trying to stay at that same line. However, Varla gets driven to the outside, smartly comes back in without taking that track cut penalty. But the Windy City defense, led by Sargentina, who obviously has her tire fixed, got those skates laced back up.
Reinforcements from Rocky arriving from the penalty box. Varla outlasts there and is lead jammer.
What a beautiful spin move in turn number four. And there is that wall of white, this time led by number 999, Yvette, your maker, skating backwards, controlling that wall. They slow down Alpha tremendously. Varla with the room and the smile and the look, gets your hips in front, calls it off. It's not a tie. It's a lead change.
That's right. Windy City coming up to 105 to Rocky's 103. A mile-wide grin on Varla Vendetta as the jam came to a close and she skated back to her bench. Penalties for Rocky now standing at 22. Windy City at 14. Rocky with more penalties but still maintaining the same degree of control, it would appear.
Yes, yes. They definitely have tightened things up. And Varla Vendetta, who's having a much better second half, no penalties yet on her. Castrator now out there for Rocky Mountain going up against Jackie Daniels. Castrator right now physically with the lead, but then Jackie Daniels pushing into her back. That wall surrounding both of them. They all get pushed to the outside. Does everybody stay legal? Yes, they do. And sneaking down the inside, lead jammer is number 1-2-2, Castrator.
And sneaking around the outside to the penalty box, Ruth and Asia for the Windy City Rollers.
Jackie Daniels is through the pack, but it's in control of Castrator. She tries to push forward. Bork, bork, bork almost cut her off, but the 4 points is there. And again, it's not a tie game. It's a 2-point lead change. Rocky 107, Windy 105. 13 minutes to go, Slim.
One thing which is tied would be the lead jams in this second period of play. 7 apiece for these teams.
So really, the difference probably was that power jam. They've been taking the lead jam and either getting 0 points. We've seen a lot of those, or those quick hit it and get out 4-pointers.
But yet only 2 points of difference
right
on the scoreboard in general, Sweet Willie. This has been a back and forth affair. Absolutely fascinating to watch.
Toxic Sonic's second time tonight out there for Rocky Mountain. She's going up against 3-1-2 Killanoy. Tonic gets driven to the outside. Sargentina drives a hip into her. Unfortunately, getting caught in that mix was Killanoy. Now Killanoy finally engaging the Rocky Jammers. They drive her to the inside of turn number two. She tries the outside. She's got some room. Great cutoff block and working that inside line. We get a jammer race, Jim Slim.
They came out of the pack together, but just by a nose, or I guess a hip bone.
That's right. It's all about the hips. Got to get the hips in front of the skater. And no points for anyone.
No
12 minutes to go.
Score, yes.
107-105.
This jam is brought to you by Rydell, official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance.
And here's a great shot of the Rocky Mountain helmet covers. It's actually a silhouette of a skater's head inside the star that's on their helmet covers. Beautiful, beautiful piece of artwork there. And it's being worn by Castrator as she goes up against number 25, Varla Vendetta. Castrator.
Wow.
She's through.
Speed from Castrator. And this is late in the contest. She is able to summon up some energy to put into those legs. She's around the mountain again and inside the pack.
Varla Vendetta hot on her wheels. Varla says, I want one. No points for anyone. Varla wanted one and it did not happen, but a victory for Windy City because you're right, the speed that Rocky Mountain got the lead jam.
But Varla Vendetta able to match that speed and play catch up just to keep both teams off the scoreboard. The inner mathematician coming out, of course, demanding that point, but nothing happening.
74-23, triple shot Misto on the line for Rocky Mountain. Her first jam of the evening as they're dipping into that bench. We haven't seen Sweet Mary Payne since she took her helmet off on the bench after an apparent injury. Sargentina drives Misto to the inside. Meanwhile, number 777, Ying of Fire, seeing nothing but those Rocky Mountain jerseys, but a great little assist from Sargentina. However, they cannot stop her. She is through for the first time tonight. Triple shot. Misto is your lead jammer. The pack surges forward a little bit. Rocky Mountain, three blockers on the track, try to surround Misto. She spins to the outside. Everybody goes down. Called off. What do we get? 3 points.
Three. May Coupe head into the penalty area for Rocky also, so they continue to mount up those penalties, but still manage to maintain the full integrity of the team. That is excellent penalty management from Rocky Mountain.
So either of these teams meeting Gotham tomorrow, the kind of discipline play, different style than what Minnesota took to Gotham. That's going to be an interesting matchup tomorrow.
I would certainly agree, and it has been drawn to my attention that both Gotham and Minnesota are in the stands as we speak, studying up on their opponents for tomorrow.
Then the chess match shall continue. And now the interesting thing about Gotham, of course, Slim, is, you know, they can run, they can walk, they can play any type of. You want to play chess? Gotham can play chess with you. You want to run out? You want to hit like Minnesota did? Gotham can do that. So we are in for a treat, no matter who wins today, and it is nowhere near decided.
Whichever one of these teams wins, they will have done it by playing that small derby.
That's right. That beautiful, beautiful derby out there. Castrator on her knees, back up quickly, driven to the inside by Kenichi Wow, and the hole opens up. Jackie Daniels is your lead jammer for Windy City. Windy City down by five. They've got Castrator trapped, and it is no longer.
Lovely zig and zag there from that Jackie was. Daniels. Outside and then inside.
That was too sweet. Jackie's got the tie. She's going for the lead. However, surging up there as well. Bork, Bork, Bork says, oh no, they got 2-3, 3-2. That was an 8-2. 6-2 jam. That will put Windy in the lead by a single.
Indeed.
Point.
Bork having a word with her teammates in a how-did-that-happen sort of tone.
Yes. And, of course, Bork, the captain of the Windy City Rollers. And she has had a spectacular tournament so far. We're used to seeing Bork, you know, a great defender, lays down a lot of hits, a lot of times plays on the edge, can get into penalty trouble. She has been just unbelievably disciplined this weekend, Slim.
Just under 9 minutes remaining. 113, Windy, 112, Rocky.
They had success earlier with triple shot Misto, so she's going up against one more time. I believe it's Killanoi. Killanoi dropped to her knees in turn number two, and triple shot Misto. Two lead jams in a row. I watched Misto warm up. She's got fantastic footwork. We've seen her mainly as a blocker tonight, but she's now replaced Sweet Mary Payne as a jammer. She pushes up into that wall. Oh, Sargentina. We'll call that inadvertent contact, I think.
No change to the score. Another double zero in terms of the jam. The score has been changing, Sweet Willie, back and forth so quickly in this bout. I barely have time to take a sip of my Derbalife, the official beverage of the WFTDA announcers.
Luckily, occasionally when you're talking, Slim, I'm able to grab it, but it has been very difficult with these lead changes. Toxic Tonic on the line. She has joined that jammer rotation now for Rocky Mountain. She goes up against number 25, Varla Vendetta. Vendetta having a great second half after a rough first half. Vendetta working that outside line, getting cut off immediately. She pushes forward, goes down on her knees quickly, back up on her skates. Meanwhile, number 68, Moby Nips with the jammer takeout. Vendetta with a ton of room as her defense is locked down the Rocky Mountain jammer.
Maybe the secret to Varla Vendetta is having her sit out half of a bout, because she certainly seems happy to be back on the track and doing everything she can.
There's been a whole lot of smiles, there's been a whole lot of speed, and there's been a whole lot of points from Varla, and she's one of the reasons that Windy City has taken a 5-point lead, 117 to 112 with 7 minutes to go.
A slim lead indeed, slimmer than me, and just 5 points. That is, of course, one grand slam. What will happen next?
Well, what will happen on the Antic Boots start line is Castrator 122 goes up against 777 Ying O Fire. It's a 3-on-2 pack. Advantage goes to Rocky Mountain, as we do have some people sitting in the RED penalty box. And immediately both jammers trying to do that similar line, but Rocky Mountain with a nice double hit onto Ying O Fire. But Ying O Fire recovers nicely. A burst of speed out of nowhere comes one of the Rocky Mountain blockers with a spin. She can't stop her. Ying O Fire is your lead jammer. 999 gets in there. Yvette, your maker, and Sargentina were able to slow down Castrator. And a little bit of chance for some points by Windy.
Oh, a scissor defense there confounds Ying O Fire.
Crowd screaming at her to call it off, and she does. She did get the 3 points. Windy stretches their lead ever so slightly to 8, Slim.
6 minutes remaining in the contest. Windy 120, Rocky 112. One skater for each team in the penalty area. A little room to skate for these jammers, and who are they, Sweet Willie?
They are triple shot Misto going up against Jackie Daniels. Misto having an excellent second half, her third jam. She's had two lead jams so far and put some points on the board for Rocky Mountain. Let's see if she can do it again. Jackie Daniels is going to have something to say about it, as is the Windy City defense. They tighten her up, but Misto with a nice little move to the inside, getting cut off immediately by number 75. Bork. Great defense by Rocky Mountain at the back of the pack. Jammers going nowhere, but triple shot Misto with a little bit of room. She can't take advantage of it. And down the inside, Jackie Daniels. And an elbow getting called. The jam gets called off. I believe what happened there, triple shot Misto. Did she get lead jam and call it off quickly?
I do believe that was the case. Oh, and now we have a timeout, because I think the coaches of the teams would like some clarification on exactly how that jam ended.
Yes, and that'll give the Windy City Rollers a chance to huddle up right around the Antic Boots start line.
This is a Rocky Mountain timeout credited to them.
Interesting. They maybe saw something out there, want to change things up. No, timeout. Yes, it is Rocky Mountain.
Well, they have the chance to catch up while the lead is not so great for Windy City, so maybe just a little tweak in strategy could be the difference.
That's right. In this chess match, that might be all it takes. Windy still with two timeouts left. Bork, Bork, Bork in the penalty box for Windy. They'll have only three blockers out there to help out Killenoy.
If you folks are watching at home, I would like to direct you to check out the photos from the WFTDA photo booth sponsored by Viva Las Vegas Skates. Go to facebook.com/WFTDA.
Toxic Tonic on the line for Rocky Mountain going up against Killenoy. 4-on-3 pack advantage for Rocky. 8-point deficit they're trying to close. Windy City having a phenomenal second half. And here we go one more time. Killenoy digging in, pushing forward. A little bit of room now for Toxic Tonic. She's down to two blockers, but one of them is Kenichi Wow, who pushes her to the outside. Nice little move to the inside. Toxic Tonic getting around the tough Kenichi Wow. Lead jam, Rocky Mountain.
Pivot of Windy City going to the penalty area. That's number 68 for Windy City, Moby Nips.
She joins Bork, 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 and is now down to a two-wall. And that makes it a fairly easy 5-point pass for Rocky. They are now only down by three. And the defense of Rocky Mountain surrounding Killenoy. And there is the lead change. Rocky taking it. The penalties hurting. Oh, no, and talking about hurtful penalties. Off to the penalty box with a cut track penalty. Killenoy, it's a power jam for Rocky with 4 minutes to go. Only two blockers on the track.
This could be when it all changes, Sweet Willie.
Oh, this could be the WFTD.TV moment changer, bout changer. I don't know, we have to invent something there. But that stout.
We need terminology, folks. Tweet us about this.
Hashtag talk the number two, WFTDA. 5 more points for Rocky. Bork, 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 Kenichi Wow, and number
Toxic
81.
Toxic Tonic puts hands to hips. She calls off the jam. She looks exhausted as she returns to her bench there. Both of these teams must be completely exhausted as they have confounded each other at every turn, Sweet Will.
That's right. It hasn't been about speed. It hasn't been about big hits. It's just about constant working. The mental fatigue they must be
the
feeling as well.
The fatigue by maintaining the discipline, because we have seen this in the past. Derby girls like to unleash the fury on the track, but this has been a mental game all the way through.
So with some time left on that penalty clock, it's Castrator up against a three wall, trying to get that lead jam, trying to put Rocky Mountain a little further ahead, but Sargentina has something to say about it. They can only slow her for 10 seconds. Now they get some help out there. It's going to be a four wall for Windy on this scoring pass by Castrator. Castrator slowly approaching that wall. She's got some help up there in the form of number 31, Fiona Grapple. Grapple helps her out a little bit, but back and forth. Number 68, Moby Nips. Great defense. She gets some help.
It is all skates on deck to keep Castrator from exiting that pack.
And she gets driven out of bounds, and turn number one has to reset. She's probably going to get the points here, but the penalty is going to get burned off as Killenoy is back on the track. She's going for her initial pass. Argentina can't stop her. She goes down in turn number two. There's the 5 points Rocky was trying to get.
Argentina certainly tried, but was tripped up there just at the last moment, and Castrada had to absorb that hit.
Killenoy with a little bit of room. However, Rocky Mountain able to tighten up and push her to the inside. Now back to the outside. Killenoy, what a standout spin. And at that same moment, the Windy defense tightens up and forces Castrator all the way back in turn number two. I don't know if she doesn't know that she's not lead jammer. That's why. She cannot call this jam off.
Oh, Sargentina gives another shot to Castrator there. And again, continues to confound the jammer of Rocky Mountain. This is a blocker's game.
This is. And there she is through. Killenoy getting some points for Windy. The jam gets called off, and it is only a 12-point deficit, or pardon me, a 15-point deficit. But after that power jam, it could have been a lot worse, Slim.
Ooh-wee, Sweet Willie. I am all aflutter in the final minute and a half of this contest. Rocky Mountain 140, Windy City 125.
We've got Alpha on the line for Rocky. We've got Ying of Fire on the line for Windy. Everybody out there, nobody in the RED penalty box. Ying of Fire pushing through. She has got to get some room. She's got to get lead jammer. That Windy City defense tightening up on Alpha. They've had her number, which is number 719, all second half. There they stretch it out. Can Ying of Fire get a little more room? Engaged by 74-23, but she is through. The crowd going crazy. Ying of Fire with a minute left.
Bork, Bork, Bork heads to the penalty box. And a track cut. A track cut on Alpha Q-Up. A power jam for Windy City. They have the chance to catch up. She calls it off.
She only got four. There was a no pass, no penalty. and wondering why it didn't get called off. The whistles were blowing. Everybody's still kind of skating. Timeout getting called, I think, by Wendy. A little bit of confusion there as she was on her back trying to call it off. She's looking around wondering what happened. We'll get some clarification here. But what we do know, it's an 11-point lead. It's a power jam for the rest, for the next probably 40 seconds, I would think, Slim. And it's in Wendy's favor.
Perhaps coming down to a photo finish. It has been close all the way through, but Rocky managing to pull ahead just a little bit. 38 seconds on that clock. Wendy at 129. Rocky, a score of 140. Wendy standing on that antique boot jammer line, arms in the air. They're saying they're ready.
Oh, and you know what? Ying of Fire just gave some instruction to Athena DeCrime. Ying of Fire walked out there, pointed at Athena DeCrime, said, "You got this. You got this." She must have said it a half a dozen times, pointing in her face. Wendy City is pumped. So we're going to have a little bit of an official timeout, I think, just to make sure everybody's happy.
And this official timeout is brought to you by Green Monster.
You are correct, Slim. So, yeah, they've got to make sure everything is properly in place with an 11-point lead. Rocky Mountain's out there. This may turn into an official review as Rocky is trying to talk. It's not trying to. They actually are talking
to
our
head. They've called that an official review, yes.
Yes, it has changed to an official review. We're going to get our referees huddling up here, and we will explain what's happening. But got to get this all straightened out.
Windy City on their benches maintaining, fists in the air, indicating that they are ready to proceed.
Oh, but I just love the emotion that Ying of Fire had. She was just screaming at
Ying of Fire has had a fantastic tournament, Willie.
She really has.
And she is fired up, and it just obvious by her behavior.
And, you know, sometime tomorrow, we got to start thinking about MVPs. We're going to need a jammer to blocker MVP, and Ying of Fire has got to be in consideration for that, because you're right, she's had a standout tournament. And you look at Wendy, you got Kenichiwa, Sergeant Tina, and Moby Nips, and Bork, all just showing the strength. Windy defense.
Yes, indeed, the strength of the defense on both of these teams as they have absolutely ground each other down to stumps,
yes,
in this contest.
Absolutely.
Has been a thing to behold. I hope everybody watching on WFTDA.tv has enjoyed what they've seen. Please let us know at #talk2WFTDA and let us know if you have been as emotionally wrung out by this bout as we have.
I may not have anything left for the final two bouts of the day. But in Rocky Mountain, no standout blocker on that team. Although Triple Shot Miso has done a great job. Make You Pay has done a fantastic job. But they worked so well as a team. They become a bunch of interchangeable parts out there. No matter who's out there, whether it's a three wall or a four wall, Rocky's done a great job on defense. Here we're going to get some clarification.
Yeah, it was just a clarification that they were challenging the cut call on the jammer. And the call stands, so everything is keeping on going. Everything is hunky-dory for Wendy right now, as they are still in this power jam position for the last jam of the game.
11-point lead. Power jam, Wendy City. Athena DeCrime pushing that wall forward. They can only let her go so long. She almost was through, and May Q Pay drives a hip into her. That's going to burn some time off that penalty clock. But now, Athena DeCrime, only 11 points is what she needs. She's going for 5 right here, but she crashes that wall.
She's got to do it solo. Her teammate's at a standstill, but she makes the back block.
And the tables turn. Coming out of the box is Alpha. We only got 6 seconds on the clock, but Slim, we got no lead jammer. This is going the full 2 minutes. Anything can happen. Kenichi, while engaging Alpha. Alpha being almost cautious out there, not wanting to engage. And also Sergeant Tina drives a shoulder into her.
Sergeant Tina pushing her out, trying to force that cut, but just as effectively forcing her to skate all the way back.
But Alpha, with only 1:10 to go in this bout, content to just coast forward. Kenichi, while trying to engage her, a little bit of help. She finds a bit of room, and she is through. Sergeant Tino tries to shut the door in turn number 1, and she is now on her scoring
Athena
pass.
Athena DeCrime has returned to the track. Both jammers on the track. No lead.
52 seconds to go. It's still an 11-point bout. Cut off on the inside was Athena DeCrime.
Bork takes out Alpha, but Alpha maintains her skates and continues.
And that defensive battle is just unbelievable. A little bit of room for Athena DeCrime, and coming out of nowhere is the Rocky defense. both jammers, a little bit of whip right into Sargentino, who absolutely drops the hammer. It was an elbow of a hammer, and the 5 points goes to Rocky. 22 seconds to go. That might be the final nail in the coffin.
Sargentino heads to the box.
And defense, 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 as they have got Athena to the crime locked down right now to burn the rest of the time off the clock. It's not going to be official for a few minutes, but right now it's 150-129. Rocky looks like they're going to the big show.
Rocky Mountain will face Gotham tomorrow.
But the ticket is punched. Whoa, last team to beat Gotham in sanctioned play. Who was it, Slim?
It was Rocky Mountain. And it happened, well, I had a little more hair back then. It was at the 2010 championships. But Rocky, they've done it before, and they're going to face Gotham tomorrow.
In windy Minnesota, who play occasionally. They have eight bouts that they have played, with Windy taking seven of those and one of them ending in the infamous tie. So we're going to have an unbelievable matchup. This one, we're waiting for it to go official. 150-133 is the unofficial, but I'm pretty sure this one's going in the books as that, Slim.
Usually when you look back on a bout, you can say, do you remember that big hit? Do you remember that one jam? This was not one jam. This was a game that was certainly more than the sum of its parts, Sweet Willie.
That's right. How do you develop a highlight film from this one when almost every jam was a highlight film?
Just slowly building in momentum until that fantastic finish. And I would say, jammers everywhere, buy your blocking core around, because this was a defensive battle. And it shows the true potential of a blocking crew that is operating on all cylinders.
And that's teams at any level can play like this. And in fact, I would encourage you, if you're a Derby team out there at any level, watch this bout and learn from it. It was a clinic on how Derby can be played. Now, we still got a timeout there. We've got captains, we've got coaches, everybody talking to the officials. It has not gone official. In fact, they're actually pointing to Windy as a timeout for Windy, but really it is an official review. Oh, yes, it is. It is an official review. My apologies. They're going to clear
Windy
things up.
Windy did have that official review available, so they, you know, no reason not to use it, Sweet Willie.
That's right, because what if something was mixed and, you know, we have one more jam? The possibility is there, and we're going to get some clarification. And the white team, Windy, is contesting the penalty that was assessed on the jam. And, of course, that penalty was on Athena the crime, and that really was the difference maker on that jam. She started out as a power jam, Slim, got some points, then took that penalty.
Yes, and was forced to exit the track, and things proceeded as they did from there, leading us here, where we still are in that official timeout.
And it's been going on for over 2 minutes now. Rocky Mountain looking tentatively happy. And on the edge of their seats, Windy City, as they wait for this one to clear up.
Bork, 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 having some word to the troops there, saying we are not conceding anything until the referees make their decision.
That's right. And if it does turn out to be a Windy City, Minnesota third place game tomorrow, only one team can make it to the championship from that one. That will be a barn burner. Give me whatever cliche you got.
Well, considering the storied history between the two teams, yes.
That's right. Minnesota never beating Windy. However, Minnesota possibly playing the best game they ever have played against Gotham earlier today.
And only one penalty separating these teams. Rocky Mountain had 26 throughout the bout. Windy City 27. A massive display of discipline, considering that with that number of penalties, only one skater had more than four, and it was evenly distributed throughout the teams. Excellent penalty management, I would say.
That was. And something we definitely have not seen from Windy City, but they have got incredible discipline this year come tournament time, and I'm very, very impressed by them. We are almost ready to solve this one. The explanation being given to the coaches and captains right now on the floor. And we're going to see what is going to happen. This is amazing. Fans standing. We've got two more great bouts to go to see who's going to end up in the fifth place game.
I see over there some of the Minnesota skaters were cheering their counterparts, Windy City, maybe looking forward to what might transpire tomorrow if they were to meet.
It will be a good one, and we want you to make sure you join us on WFTDA.tv for all the action. Two more bouts tonight.
Yes, standing, waiting in the wings, waiting just as anxiously as everyone. We have Oklahoma and Steel City coming up next.
The tournament darlings, Oklahoma, coming in here. Nobody knew who they were, and they have played a wonderful, wonderful derby, and there it is. It is going in the books.
And yes, it is now official. That is the final score. Rocky Mountain 150 going on to face Gotham tomorrow. Windy City a score of 133 in a bout that went back and forth all day long.
That was unbelievable. So Rocky Mountain punches their ticket to the championships. They will face Gotham tomorrow to try and get that bye, that number one seed, Windy City. They got smiles on their faces. They got to be a little disappointed because they were so close, but they get a chance tomorrow against Minnesota. I'm exhausted, Slim.
I am too, sweet Willie. I felt like we were down there with them, although we're certainly nowhere near as athletically inclined.
That's right. It doesn't take much to exhaust us, apparently, but, you know, what a wonderful clinic in Derby. I haven't had a chance to see a lot of Rocky Mountain. I've seen a lot more of Windy City, and I've heard a lot about Rocky Mountain. They did not disappoint today, and they definitely teased us yesterday, trying out some stuff. They didn't show all their hand yesterday. They played a wonderful, wonderful bout today, as did Windy City. Both teams now shaking hands. You might see them meet again at the champs in Milwaukee. It's possible.
This is a possibility, sweet Willie. About full of discipline and a lot of fun to watch.
All right. Well, we're going to have an interview down on the floor. We're waiting for that to get organized as they're going to grab one of the skaters. Who do you pick? Who do you put on camera to discuss this one?
It was such a team effort from both Rocky and Windy that, yeah, do you choose an individual when it was really, you know, the work of many hands, many skates to make it happen?
Absolutely. Well, we may not be having a interview after this one. Yeah, John Madding's going to check things. But they may not be able to get anybody on the camera. Yes, just phenomenal, phenomenal derby.
You are watching the Division I playoffs from Asheville, North Carolina, of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. Warming up on the track now, wearing the red, Oklahoma. They will be facing in the yellow and black, Steel City. That is coming up next.
So, Slim, let's review what we've got coming up tomorrow, because we've got some things settled. Some of our games are settled. Let me get my bracket out here.
Let us get our brackets. Like folks at home will be getting out their cheese ball bracket bonanza brackets.
I can't wait to see tonight how many people are left with perfect brackets. Nonetheless, for Sunday, 10 o'clock in the morning, bright and early, what do we got, Slim? Columbia versus Mad Rolling Dolls?
Yes.
Sorry, I set you up there.
You did. I'm looking at the bracket, yes. So at 10 o'clock, yep. That will be...
That's
Columbia
for ninth place.
And the Mad Rolling Dolls, yes, for the 9-10 bout.
That's right. Columbia came in as the number 10 seed. They're 41st in the league. They're the ones that kind of snuck into the tournament, the last seed to get in the tournament. They would love to go home as a number 9 seed. Mad Rolling Dolls ran into a tough Windy City. That gave them some trouble. So they are going to be in that 9-10 game at 10 o'clock. And then we will go to the 12 p.m. game.
Coming up at noon will be the loser of the game, which is about to happen between Oklahoma and Steel City, and they will face the loser of the Houston-Nashville game, which is happening at 8 o'clock this evening. And it looks like we have our interview set up, and we will be switching over to Double H. She is with Triple Shot Misto. Thanks, folks.
Double H here with Triple Shot Misto. Congratulations on that win. Super exciting. So much confusion at the end there. What was going through your head during that deliberation?
You know, we felt like we had it, that there wasn't any way they could swing 18 more points, but you never know. I mean, it could constitute another jam at the end of the game, so we were just kind of patiently waiting. We were pretty confident that penalty on the white jammer was legitimate, but it's still scary.
Also legitimate, Windy City really brought it today. They came in a seed behind you guys. What were you expecting from them?
You know, we were expecting a tough, hard-hitting game. Windy is, they're not easy to play, and they hit hard. They know their strategy. They've got great walls. So we were expecting it to be a tough, hard-hitting game, and they did not disappoint.
Well, one thing I know that fans were expecting was to expect the unexpected from Rocky Mountain this season. You guys had a really interesting season. I think you lost to Texas and Rose City.
Yeah.
Those are the two games that you lost. Still a great record. Let us know a little bit about what has gone on over the past two seasons, climate-wise, within the culture of your team. It's changed a lot, I know.
Yeah, you know, we have had quite a bit of turnover, but we've got a great core. We have so much talent, and I feel more like a team than we ever have. I've played with Rocky for the last three seasons, and this season has felt so much different. We just feel kind of like a unit, like one. We've been working together. We all support each other. We don't blame one another when mistakes happen. We win as a team, and we lose as a team. So it's really been an awesome feel.
So another hive mind here this weekend, going on to play Gotham, which is the other hive mind. What are you looking forward to in that game?
You know, Gotham is arguably the best team in women's flat track roller derby. I don't know how you could argue against that. So we're really looking forward to playing them and see kind of how we stack up and what we can learn from them. And, you know, we're going to put up a good fight. We are not going to go in there expecting to lose. We always think we're going to win, and we're going to do our best to do that against a phenomenal team.
And you're also one of the teams that has benefited from the division-based structure as opposed to the regional-based structure. Talk a little bit about that.
You know, we previously were in the Western region, which is arguably so tough. I mean, we had 6 to 7 teams that could have easily been in the championship tournament every single year. So it's been nice, although we miss our good friends DRD, hey. It's been nice to kind of have different teams to play and have a different experience at playoffs this year.
A different experience. Division One playoffs. That's going to be our new slogan.
Perfect.
Well, thank you, Triple Shot Misto, for joining me. Congratulations on the win. We will see you tomorrow facing off against Gotham Girls Roller Derby.
We'll be here.
Woo, you're not going to want to miss it. We're going to take a quick break to thank our sponsors, and then we'll be right back on WFTDA.TV.
Dang it, Mo. I can't stop. I keep running into everything except the kitchen sink.
Man, tell me about it. These toast knots suck. I tried all of them. They feel like plastic, and they keep popping off the stems.
I cannot stop. I wish somebody would help us. Help us. Help us.
Do you hear that? I think we're needed.
Captain Antic, can you help me?
Antic skate boots?
Reckless wheels? I wish somebody would help us. Help us.
It's okay, guys. I've got this one.
Wow! It's the Gumballer!
Try these Gumball Toe Stops. All natural rubber, no dyes, traction for any surface, and these will never pop off.
Jeez, thanks, mister!
This commercial is brought to you by Green Monster Roller Sports, Gumball Toe Stops, and Derby Skins.